right back and better than ever for another continuity practice session. This is the heart and soul of success in freeing ourselves from fear, from unhappiness, from misery, from all the troubles that we have. The ego will never ever do this practice for you. It will never tell you about the continuity problem, because once you recognize this and practice it, the ego cannot hold you to this self-deception any longer. So we practice, we say, I do not have a failure problem. I have a continuity problem, yes. The failure problem holds no value for me whatsoever. The vision of oneness is what has value for me, and only the vision of oneness has value for me. There is no other value, because it resolves the continuity problem. I don't have a momentum problem. I have a continuity problem. The momentum problem does not have any value for me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have an imprisonment problem. I do have a continuity problem. The imprisonment problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a debt problem. I do have a continuity problem. The debt problem doesn't have any value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a money problem. I do have a continuity problem. The money problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a job problem. I do have a continuity problem. The job problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a functioning problem. I do have a severe continuity problem. The functioning problem has zero value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. There is nothing else that has value for me. I do not have a deceit problem. I do have a continuity problem. The deceit problem does not have the slightest value for me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Nothing else has value for me. I do not have a vulnerability problem. I do have a severe continuity problem, yes. The vulnerability problem, no value for me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me, because it resolves the one and only problem I have, which is the continuity problem. I don't have a moving problem. I do have a continuity problem. The moving problem does not have any value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a body problem. I do have a continuity problem. The body problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a choice problem. I do have a continuity problem. It's the only problem that I have. The choice problem doesn't have any value whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a freedom problem. I do have a continuity problem. It's the only problem that I have. I have no other problem other than the continuity problem. The freedom problem has absolutely no value for me whatsoever. None. Zero. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Nothing else has value for me. I do not have an experience problem. I do have a continuity problem. The experience problem has no value for me whatsoever. None. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. There isn't any other value for me whatsoever. I do not have a feeling problem. I have a severe continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. The feeling problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Nothing else has value for me. I do not have a pressure problem. I do have a continuity problem. Yes. The pressure problem has no value for me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have an unpleasant problem. I have a continuity problem. The unpleasant problem, no value whatsoever to me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have an undesirable problem. I do have a continuity problem. The undesirable problem doesn't have any value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Nothing else has value. Nothing else. I do not have an inescapable problem. I do have a continuity problem. The inescapable problem has no value for me. None. Only the vision of oneness holds value for me. Nothing else holds value for me. I do not have a learning problem. I have only one problem, and that's the continuity problem. I have no other problem. The learning problem, no value. No value, no value, no value. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. Nothing else has value for me. I do not have a waiting problem. I do have a continuity problem. The waiting problem, no value, no value, no value. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have an improvement problem. I do have a continuity problem. The improvement problem, absolutely worthless, no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me, and that has total value for me. Nothing else has value, but only the vision of oneness has value for me, because it solves the one and only problem I have, which is the continuity problem. That's it. I don't have any other problem. Nada. No other problem. I have no other problem but the continuity problem. That's it. Only the vision of oneness solves it. So, this is how we align with the remedy, with the truth and the answer to our one and only problem. This is how we align with it. The more we align with the vision of oneness as the one only value there is for us, solving the only problem we have, continuity problem, the easier it becomes to see through the massive self-deception that we have been engaged in for so long, massive self-deception. We are trying to put ourselves in a situation so terrible for us, so terrible, that we insist it's impossible that we could have chosen that for ourselves. Therefore, we insist that we're not free. It was imposed upon us. See, we didn't choose, it was imposed upon us. Therefore, our will has triumphed over God's, because God's will is perfect freedom for us forever and forever. And we're saying we're not free, so we must have been able to have a will stronger than God's to say no, to imprison what God made free. Therefore, we insist we must be greater than God. Therefore, we insist that we must be prime creator, the true prime creator. Therefore, we're going to then decree happiness forever for us, happiness forever. So we're trying to succeed at failure. We're trying to succeed at failure. It's impossible to do so, impossible. We can never lose our freedom. Everything, every last situation we've ever been experiencing, ever been in, we have chosen to for that situation. We have chosen it. But we're trying to choose terrible situations to provide evidence that we couldn't possibly have chosen this. This is the self-deception that we have been engaged in for so long, and it's why we have this continuity problem, because we wouldn't know how to function hardly. You know, we think, I don't know how I could function without time and space and form and trying to fail and self-deception and all that, right? And I'm afraid of true happiness. I'm afraid of my freedom, my happiness. That's a continuity problem, continuity issue. But we still are totally free, you see. We just don't want to exercise, we don't want to be aware of this freedom. That's a continuity problem. We don't have any other problem at all. We are still completely free. We are not a body, we are free. We are as God created us, and through perfectly so still. And yet we're afraid to accept this and realize it. So no problem except the continuity problem. Don't have any problem except the continuity problem. And the vision of oneness is what solves the continuity problem. Practice, 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 and you will save yourself virtually uncountable years of misery by just practicing this a little bit. Okay, very great. That's it for this one.